Welcome to video number 41 on working with train controller. This video is about a special situation, loading of wagons from a silo. Let's have a look. This is the little layout. There is a silo here in the middle block. And the task at hand is that when the train drives in, it stops here at the silo. Then the silo fills the first car, and when that is done, the train has to advance the length of exactly one wagon, and then the silo fills the second car, then we advance again to the third wagon, and so on, until the last car is filled. So what we need to do is to advance our train every x seconds, exactly one wagon length. And that can be done in two different ways. The simplest way is without any additional hardware. We simply drive the train on a set speed for a given time. And that is only accurate enough under these three conditions. That means that our engines must drive predictable speed-wise. So they must have load compensation, otherwise their speed will not be predictable enough, or they stutter too much, probably. Then all the wagons in the trains must have the same size. Well, per train that can be different, but in one and the same train they must have the same size. And also in the amount of wagons in the train must stay the same during a play session. If one of these conditions is not met, then we can still refer to another method, that is by using a sensor. It can be a light sensor or a magnet, a reed switch magnet sensor, that detects if the next car is at the current at the correct position and we stop the train at that moment. That will be the subject of the next video. So let's have a look. We have for fun, I have prepared two trains, one with two wagons and one with five wagons. We can see that over here. And well, let's first drive in that two wagon train. I have already placed it over here. And let's see what happens in which sequence. Well, first of all, the train is on a schedule towards the silo block. And there are two flagmen, and the flagmen have the task to detect which of the trains is coming in. So let's have a look in edit mode inside this flagman. What is happening here? What we are doing here is the trigger of this first flagman is the combi group of a train that is currently inside the silo block. And which train? That is the train called two wagons. So that flagman detects if the two wagon train is there. And what happens in that case is the operation is we advance the wagon counter by two. That's all. And then, not surprisingly, the other flagman is advancing the wagon counter by five, and it does that only if it detects that the train called five wagons is inside that block. So that's the task of the flagman, and when the train is in, the counter is at the number of wagons that the train has. Well, the next thing is we have to start that sequence of advancing one wagon x times. And how is that sequence started? That sequence is started over here in the schedule. Double clicking it will show the properties, and we will see that at the finish of the schedule we start an activity, and that activity has the operation to delay 5 seconds and then start the macro next wagon. Aha, okay, so when the schedule is finished, the train has come to a halt. After 5 seconds we start advancing to the next wagon. Well, let's now have a look inside that macro to see what it does. The macros are hidden over here in the edit menu. Look for the macros, and we have only one macro that is called next wagon, and inside that macro we have the operations like such. The first thing we do is to put our loading light on green, signaling us that we are now loading. Then the next thing we do is decrease the wagon counter. Then we start driving with a low speed for a certain amount of time. And this is the critical part that you have to fine-tune a little bit, because of course this combination of speed and time exactly calculates the length of one wagon, represents the length of one wagon. So that takes a little bit of fine-tuning, but after two or three iterations that should be okay, and luckily we can even fine-tune it up to a millisecond, so it should be possible to get the proper advance centimeters. And then of course we stop the train again, then we have a delay for the silo to do its so-called dumping of the bulk goods. Some people even have built real silos on their layout that really is opening a valve and dumping some stuff in the cars. That is of course very funny. And then after a while we stop loading the car, and then we have to test if the counter is not zero. We go back to the beginning, go to level next, and then it starts again. Or if the counter is at zero, we skip this go to statement and we are finished and we put our loading light back on red. That is what happens. So let's just put it to the test and have a look how that works on the demo. I can start it by going out of edit mode, start the simulator and start the schedule. Yeah, my train is starting. Yeah, we can see over here it is driving. Yeah, there it is. Well, now we have to wait till it reaches this block, and then one of the flagmen will flag which train it is and it will update this counter. Let's have a look if that happens. Yeah, we are driving not very fast at 20 kilometers, so it takes a while before we are in the block, but we should be there any moment now. Let's be patient. Yeah, there we are, braking. Yeah, my flagman has lit and the counter is at 2. Loading is not yet happening because first the schedule has to be completely stopped, and that is almost done right now. Yes, there we train stopped. Now after 5 seconds my loading will start. Yeah, it did. We go down to wagon 1. We started, as you can see, the car, and we are now loading wagon 1, and now we started the car and the train again, and we are loading wagon 2, and then we are stopping, we are finished, we are done at and the loading light goes off, and now we can start automatically. Of course we can start a next schedule to drive to the exit and then wherever we need to go. So this is how it works. Well, let me now try to see if we can also get that to work. I should remove this train and place the 5 wagon train over here. And now I have a pop-up video that should show that it really works. So we can start that video and we can start this this train driving in simulation. And we will see, yeah, it is going over here. And we will see that the video shows that it is accurate enough. It is only a few millimeter tolerance, so that should be in normal circumstances accurate enough to do this task, even for a long train of say 10 or 20 cars maybe. But if it doesn't, then we still can revert to a method using some additional hardware, a sensor that detects the next wagon. That will be the next video. Okay, my counter is now at 5 and the loading will start any moment now. Yeah, there it is, train is running, and we can see that the advance of the wagons is accurate enough every time for 5 wagons in a row to do this job perfectly well without any additional hardware. Yeah, there it goes again. And yes, it stopped, and well, we can see the wagon is at exactly the right spot. And yeah, there it goes again. My counter is nicely decreasing. Yeah, it stopped again at exactly the right spot. One more car to go. Yeah, there we go to the final car. Yes, also that one has stopped at exactly the right spot. No more cars to go. Yeah, the loading light went off, so the job is finished and we can advance to start the next schedule to wherever we need to go. Well, this was it. The next video will show something similar, but then using a sensor, a detector, to detect the end of the, or the beginning of a car so that the train can stop at exactly the right spot. Thank you for watching and maybe see you back there. Bye bye.